Greg's been coming to look after my tomatoes. Have a look at these. These are the peat pots, or whatever you want to call them, jiffy pots. See the roots coming out? You don't have to take the tomato plant, and you don't want to take it out because it breathes through here, through the walls of the pot. It hydrates. You can see how it hydrates and it's not hydrated there. The difference? These are all the roots, the fibrous roots coming out. And that's perfect. So you're getting a nice uniform growth of roots out there. And these will be almost ready to go in the ground, providing the weather stabilizes. Where did this one come from? Now, I've had a few emails coming through saying you've been buying the big malakas and the beef steaks. Have a look at these ones here, even these ones too. All the seedlings, all the seeds that is, you've had them in the ground for two, or in seed pods for about 2 or 3 weeks and they still haven't germinated. Just be careful that you don't plant them too deep into the soil. Even if you've used good quality potting mix or seed raising mix, if you plant the seed way too deep, it takes all that longer for it to germinate. Now you need to have a heat mat, thermostat and all that. The aim is with the heat mat thermostat is to have it around 18 to 22 degrees. At the moment, it's sitting at 16 degrees. That's the heat mats. I've got a little, probe here. Here it is. Actually, it's not even sitting on it. How do you like that? See that? That's why it's not working properly. That should be sitting between the mat and the soil, and that all starts rising up again. Here, let's see if it works. Yep, it's rising up. I'm going to just put my hand over and see what happens. See how hot-blooded I am. Look at that. Yes, folks, I am a very warm-hearted person. I'm sitting at 24 degrees, 24.2. I'm heating up as I speak. Nevertheless, it does work. So that's what you're going to do. Put it in underneath between your heat mat and your soil. And if you want to set the temperature, again, emails have come through about that. Press and hold the set button. I've got it, it'll start flashing. I've got it set at 28 degrees and then go up and down and set it down at what temperature you want. So I set it at 28 degrees, press and it locks it in. Now it's at 24 because I was holding it, but it's going to start dropping because I've just put it back underneath the mat. It won't get to 28 degrees. It'll get to 23, which is comfortable. Now during the daytime, if it's a hot day, summer days, turn it off. Because you've got, you know, 18, 20 degrees outside in a little hothouse, it'll get to 30 degrees in there without the heat mat. You don't need the thermostat. It's great for nights. Now, what I've done is I've taken the roof off here and I have not put it on at nighttime. So during the daytime, it's off, and I've left it off at nighttime because I'm starting to harden off my seedlings. See these ones up here? How they're sitting nice and strong and upright? Even though Mum has come along and watered them, the little ones are a little bit still slow to get up there, but they are still upright, whereas these ones down here, that difference, there's only 60 centimeters difference, but they're sitting below here. They are still soft. Now these need to be hardened off. They're going to come up here and I'm going to move all this down to there. So they need to be hardened off. You don't want to go from hot to cold like that. You'll freak the plant out. It'll go backwards on you. It will survive. Most times it will survive, but it'll stress the plant out too much. You need to harden them off. That's a slow progressive development over a week. So if you've got your seedlings and they're soft looking and a little bit limp, they need to be hardened off. Take them up, put them up in a high spot like that. I'm not going to do these tonight. I'm going to do it in the morning with the lid off. And then by the afternoon, they'll toughen up a little bit and they should be ready by tomorrow night, providing the temperature, tomorrow's night temperature, doesn't get below 10 degrees. That will knock them out again. So we've got to monitor all these until we're ready to plant them out into the garden. And for those who are struggling to get their seeds to germinate, remember they need the warmth to start with, the seeds not too deep, keep them moist but not too wet, and don't let them dry out for too long a period. Otherwise the seed will take all that longer to germinate. So make sure your seeds aren't too deep, and always use your Liquid Gold and Eco Boost and Black Grit once you plant them into the ground to get the big beautiful fruit, and enjoy the vegetables as well. From me, Vasily Maresi. For more info, go to vasilisgarden.com.